ਤਨ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਗ੍ਰੰਥ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਦੀ, ਗੁਰੂ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਸਾਧ ਸੰਗਤ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀਓ, ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ, ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ। ਵੀ ਬਲੈਸਡ ਅਗੇਨ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਗੈਦਰਡ ਟੁਗੈਦਰ ਟੁਡੇ। ਵੀ ਆਰ ਸੈਲੀਬ੍ਰੇਟਿੰਗ ਦ ਕਮਿੰਗ ਆਫ ਆਵਰ ਸੈਕੰਡ ਗੁਰੂ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਅੰਗਦ ਦੇਵ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ। ਵੀ ਆਰ ਸੈਲੀਬ੍ਰੇਟਿੰਗ ਦ ਅਵਤਾਰ ਦਿਹਾੜਾ। ਸਾਹਿਬ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਅੰਗਦ ਦੇਵ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਖੇਮ ਟੂ ਦਿਸ ਵਰਲਡ ਐਂਡ ਦੇ ਵਰ ਨੋਨ ਐਟ ਦੈਟ ਟਾਈਮ ਐਜ਼ ਭਾਈ ਲੈਣਾ ਜੀ। They came to this world and their parents had already been blessed and met Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. And Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji had already blessed and gave that blessing that in that house would come the second form of Akal Purakh Vaheguru. Bhai Lehna Ji in their young age was actually a believer of a Devi, of a deity. And they would be a leader and even a preacher spreading the message of that deity. Now that shouldn't be a question in our minds, saying if they're the form of Vaheguru, if they're going to become a Sikh of the Guru, why are they worshipping a deity, a Devi? That is actually a teaching to us, because it doesn't matter which background we come from, which faith or belief set or non-belief set we follow. It doesn't matter. We can always find Vaheguru, because if that happened with the Gurus themselves, they've shown that in their time on this earth, even though they were all knowing they are Vaheguru on this earth, they're just showing us that it doesn't matter what line we follow, we can always change and follow the true path of Gursikhi and find Vaheguru within it. Doesn't matter what belief set we have or non-belief, whichever way it is. So Bhai Lehna Ji would be a worshipper of Devi. And one time, going on a yatra, going on a pilgrimage, they realized that there is a great saint known as Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. Little did they know at that time that they are not merely just a saint, they are the form of Vaheguru on this earth. They realized that they want to do darshan. And when they're going towards to do darshan and they're going on their horse, actually, Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji know, because they're the one who is pulling Bhai Lehna Ji, because it's time for everything to come forth. It's time for Guru Sahib Ji to show their form. Bhai Lehna Ji to practice in the sanctuary of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji and then show their form as the second Guru. Bhai Lehna Ji, as they're riding their horse towards Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji's house, Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji come out of their house and walk them in. Bhai Lehna Ji thinks that they're going to the house of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji and this must be a servant of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. But Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji is showing the nimrata. They're already giving an ishara that Bhai Lehna Ji sat on this horse, they are going to be the Guru. They are of the Sikhs. They are going to be where the Jyot is going to be passed. Bhai Lehna Ji asked Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji, is Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji in the house? They said, yeah, if you go through that door, you will do the darshan of Guru Nanak Dev Ji. Guru Nanak Dev Ji go around the back and sit in the house, and Bhai Lehna Ji come off their horse, and when they go in, they realize that the person who came out was Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji themselves. They bow down, they beg for forgiveness, that I made you carry my horse and bring my horse in as I stayed on sat on the horse. And Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji said, what is your name? They said, my name is Lehna. And Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji said, that is right. Tu Lehna, te main Dena. You have come to take and I will be giving. Because they gave the Gurgaddi to Bhai Lehna Ji. Bhai Lehna Ji spent many years with Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji doing complete seva. The sons of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji, Bhai Sri Chand and Bhai Lakshmi Das, they would have ego that they are the sons of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji and they wouldn't partake in the seva. Even the great Gursikh Baba Buddha Sahib Ji completed seva, but in one test they couldn't complete the final test, and only there Bhai Lehna Ji passed, showing that they are the greatest Gursikh disciple. They are the best disciple. They are worthy of the Gurgaddi. They were showing that to become one with Vaheguru, you must sacrifice and give absolutely everything. And Bhai Lehna Ji did. They became Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji, the Ang of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji, the body part, showing that they are one and they are the same. Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji then went to Khadur Sahib. Khadur Sahib is where they were sent by Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. And when Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji left this world at Kartarpur, which is now just past the border of Punjab into Pakistan, Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji did their prachar from Khadur Sahib, which is towards the north of Punjab in the India side. And Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji taught Gurbani to all the Sangat of Khadur Sahib. They got them to train. They developed a Mal Akhada, a wrestling school, if you will, where wrestling and fighting was developed. They were already sowing the seeds of the teachings of Gursikhi, of the Guru Khalsa that would come later on. And then they would do great seva. Their wife, Mata Khivi Ji, who's also mentioned in Gurbani, would do seva in the Langar. And so they're already themselves showing seva, simran, and a type of sacrifice where you will have to fight in the future as Gursikh, so you need to be ready for that and ready to be able to sacrifice yourselves. Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji blessed many in Khadur Sahib. They blessed many Gursikhs who would come. They showed the righteous way. They spread the message of Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. But they had complete nimrata. But they also had biras. Humayun came, who was the emperor, Mughal emperor, and he'd lost a battle. And he came to Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji to gain a blessing. Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji is teaching Santhya, is teaching Gurbani at the time. And they didn't speak to Humayun. Humayun got so angry that he put his hand on his sword to say, I'm not being respected by this saint. Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji looked up and said, where you needed to pull that sword out and fight and win the battle, you lost. Now you're trying to do that to saintly people, to sadhus. Actually, Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji is not just a mere saint. They are the form of Waheguru on this earth. And then they blessed Humayun and they gave him a blessing that if you live and in a righteous way, your Raj will stay calm. So the Mughal Empire will stay, will come back into power. But only if you serve your people in your kingdom righteously will that power stay forever. If you don't, the time you stop being righteous, then your power will be lost, your kingdom will be lost. And we know later on the kingdom was lost at the time of Aurangzeb. That Mughal Empire was then finished and the Guru Khalsa took it over after Sri Guru Gobind Singh Sahib Ji left this world. Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji left this world at Khadur Sahib. Sri Guru Amar Das Sahib Ji came into their sanctuary and used to do their seva. Many would question Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji because they were the second guru and they just felt that Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji was the greatest. But Sri Guru Amar Das Sahib Ji pashand and found that Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji, there is no difference. They blessed Gursikhs in Khadur Sahib, like I said. They blessed them all over, far and wide, who would come to do the darshan of Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji. Those, they say, that would do the darshan of Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji, when Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji would open from their samadhi, after doing their nitname, after being affixed to Akal Purakh Waheguru Ji's Sharan, the darshan that they would give to those Sangat who were sat with them, all their disease, pains, anguishes would be taken away. Bhai Paro Ji, known as Paramhans, came to the sanctuary of Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji. And Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji was the one who taught them about being a Paramhans. A Hans is one that can separate the water from within milk. And a Paramhans is one who separates Maya, materialism, from within themselves and finds Akal Purakh Waheguru. They gave that blessing to Bhai Paro Ji, who was known as the Paramhans, the Gursikh of Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji and Guru Amar Das Sahib Ji's times. So Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji then passed on the Gurgaddi to Guru Amar Das Sahib Ji and left this world at Khadur Sahib. Khadur Sahib, the Gurdwara, is called Angita Sahib, where they were cremated, and they gave us the teachings of how the Antam Kirya, the final rites, should be performed for any Gursikh. We're celebrating the coming of Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji Maharaj, the second form of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji, the Ang, the body form, the body part of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. Tan Sahib Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji, bless us with that Gursikhi that you blessed to those Gursikhs. Make us Paramhanses. Let us understand that materialism is separate and Akal Purakh Waheguru is the way we should be going. Deho Sajjan Asis Chidiyan Jehovah Sahib Chume Lekha Katahna Shuti Akhen Khen Poolan Har Baksan Har Baksala Nanak Par Utar Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh.
Please like, comment, subscribe and share this video to spread the message of Sikhi. Make your Dasvand Safala and donate so we can create more content like this. The link is in the description below.